my ghost. On this episode of Demons Row TV, we talk. Everybody's a one percenter until it's time to do some one percenter shit. And we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything Motorcycle Club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost, I'm your host for the evening, and today we're going to talk about everybody's a one percenter until it's time to do one percenter shit. Now, the reason why we're talking about this topic, the big homie Big Kaz been telling me for a minute that we need to get on this, so we're going to hop on this, but real quick, I need you to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Shout to all my new subscribers, welcome to the row, thank you for tuning in, hit that bell so you get the notification, we drop every Wednesday, and real quick, follow the Sos the Ghost page. I got a lot coming on that page. I've been working hard. Got an album, everything coming real soon. Now let's get into it. Everybody's a one percenter until it's time to do one percenter shit. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is people that are not one percenters, constantly speaking on one percenter topics. All right? The whole thing that went down with the other channels where they were discussing, I'm not going to get too deep into it because I don't really feel like they were throwing a shot at me, and I wasn't really throwing a shot at them. I don't feel like it's no real street shit, so to go on camera and try to be tough and they're all the way on another coast from me or in the Midwest, you know what I mean? And I'm over here, like, that's lame. So, you know what I mean? Like, as men, brothers could talk to each other or whatever, but we're going to disagree on stuff. There's going to be stuff where if you speak on the one percenters, I'm going to speak up. You know what I mean? Same token, if they have stuff that they feel, you know, is important, they gonna speak up. I just don't like the names and the faces with the cases. You know what I'm saying? That's just something deep in my moral high ground. Like, we can't be putting brothers' cases out there. You know what I'm saying? Because it can affect people's life. People do go away because of stuff that's shown on TV, on YouTube, or comments that people make that could be in the club. There's a lot of different situations with that. Let's get into the topic. Everybody's a one percenter until it's time to do one percenter shit. You would think that this topic, we're gonna go into some like gangster shit and it's all about putting in work and stabbing and shooting and all that. That's not what I want to talk about. The real deal of being a one percenter, what is a one percenter? A one percenter is a brotherhood. You're in a club that it takes a lot to get into. So what do you want? You want a lot from your brothers. You expect a lot from your brothers and they expect a lot from you. That's what it's about. The 1% is about dedication. A lot of people think it's just about being tough or being the biggest guy or the strongest guy. That's not what it's about. It's about dedication, putting your time in. Your brothers expect you to be there. If their bike goes down and they're on the side of the road, it doesn't matter what time of night it is. You need to be there for your brother. And you need to ask yourself, when you wanna, like, for all these people that wanna be, look like the tough guy and get down with a 1% club, you need to ask yourself, dedication wise, is this something that I really wanna be involved with? Cause it's more of a sacrifice than being a tough guy. It's more discipline than being a tough guy. A lot of 1%ers are very tough men, but you have to think about it. There gotta be something alpha about you that you can just persevere through and do what it takes to become a one percenter, because it's not an easy thing to do. It's a long process. Now, don't get it twisted. There's clubs out here that are handing out cuts like hotcakes. But a lot of the 1% clubs, it's not easy to get into. They're gonna background check you. You know, they're gonna find out about what type of person you are, what kind of resume do you have. Somebody has to vouch for you. You can't just walk up to a club and become a prospect. You gotta put time in. So it's more about dedication than being tough. So when we say everybody's a 1% until it's time to do 1% shit, I know situations where there's people that are in a club that are paraplegic. They were in the club, they were wearing the cut, and they're no longer, well, actually they're still technically a member. They never got their vest taken, and they're just paraplegic, and nobody checks up on a brother. You know what I mean? Like, I know a lot of situations where real brotherhood doesn't go down. I thank God that in my situation, I got some real brothers. When I went down on my accident, my brothers were there for me. That's what it's about, being a one percenter. But I've seen situations where brothers go down, and it's like the brothers that are questioning him about his bike and stuff, they care more about the fact that he doesn't have a bike than his health. Like, ask your brother if he's okay first. That's not real brotherhood, to be like, oh, you gotta have your bike within a certain amount of time or whatever. To me, that's not brotherhood. If your brother gets hurt, you give him the time to get back on his feet. Now, you have to have a motorcycle to be in a motorcycle club. But if you get hurt, if you go down, support your brother. And if you got so much to say about a brother not having a bike, put that bread up. You put that bread up. You put that bike in your name. You know what I'm saying? Put that bike in your old lady's name. Don't down your brother. Being a one percenter is not just about making every meeting. It's not just about going to all the club events. It's about truly being a brother. Look at it like this. Your birth brother from your mom. Like, if I don't know who has brothers, who don't. But if you have a birth brother, is he less of your brother if he didn't go to a certain party last weekend? You know what I mean? He's still your brother. He's always gonna be your brother. And that's what it is. In a 1% club, your brother's your brother. He's always gonna be your brother no matter what. I believe that I have brothers that are not in my club anymore, and I still consider them brothers. I'm not the type, like, if you're not out bad, you're still a brother. You're technically still a brother. Like, the vest to me doesn't make you a brother. The time that we put in, those roads that we rode on, that's what makes you a brother. Not just the vest, not just patches. People are too enamored with the look, trying to look like something. And that's why I say, earn everything. Don't wear no stitch on stuff, and just wear the essentials of what you earned, because it's a greater feeling. And let me tell you something, clicks in clubs is not 1% of shit. Like, everybody's your brother, not just certain brothers in the club. Everybody's your brother. Don't cause divide. You make yourself smaller. It kills me how you can have like 30 niggas, it's 30 of y'all together, and people start fractioning off, and then eventually you want to be separate and all that. That doesn't make sense to me. You're stronger together. Even if you just have fun with other brothers a little bit more, take that time out to bond with your other brothers too, because you don't know the relationships that you can build just with all brothers, and what you can learn and how you guys can get money together. There's so much things that you could do. So the clicky shit in clubs, stop doing that shit. Like, people cause divide within their own clubs. How will we ever try to unite and squash the beefs with other clubs and all these wars that's been going on since the 60s and 70s if we can't even get along with each other? So we gotta start from square one and get ourselves right before we can make any changes, before we can help the Mongols with the Save the Patch case, before we can help any other club with the stuff that they're going through. We gotta get ourselves right. And in this community, I believe we can do anything, because the things we do in this community, it never gets broadcasted, but we do a lot of shit. And that's any club, MC, RC, AC. I wanna stress that on this channel, when I talk about 1% of topics, it's because I'm speaking from my perspective. If I was an RC, I would say RC, blah, 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 whatever the topic is, president, whatever it is. but I'm a one percenter, so I say it from my perspective. But that doesn't mean that it doesn't apply to all of us, to the whole culture. So I don't want you to feel like if you see a 1% topic that it means that it doesn't apply to you, or you know, it's just watching what's going on with the 1%ers. There's a lot of nosy vibes going on too on the internet. Like, y'all gotta stop wanting to feed into such so much negativity. Like, stop giving negativity light. Stop seeing a link about brothers doing something good and skipping over it to see another dried up Mongols, Hell's Angels, pagans shot, whatever, or got locked up. Stop feeding into that bullshit, because there's a lot of positive that these clubs do, and the stigma of all this drama is bullshit. It's not, I mean, really think about it. How often, just think about your neighborhood where you're at. How often do you see a 1% club doing anything? Like, let's be realistic here. Let's stop bullshitting already. A lot of people are just surfing on the internet, seeing stuff, and it's in random different places all over the world. There's stuff that goes on all over the world in every group. You could pick any semblance of any type of group and say, oh, something happened in Afghanistan or whatever. You know, it's religions that have stuff that's going on all over the world. So you can't paint it like it's only 1%. It's nonsense and it's really lame. And I really want y'all to get conscious about this and stop being programmed. And another light note, I just wanted to say something. This whole coronavirus thing, don't get too caught up in feeding. This is another topic where I say people are feeding too much energy into negativity. All down my timeline, it was to the point where I had to like close my phone. Because all down my Instagram, follow me on Instagram too, at Demons Row, at SostaGhost _. Those are my Instagrams. But I'm looking up and down my timeline, and it's all fucking coronavirus and all that. And then what happens? Old lady's mom tells me, in Walmart, everybody's fighting over toilet tissue paper. So the big companies are laughing at you. Like, they're just sitting there laughing at everybody, because what's happening, you have to look at who stands to gain from whatever's being promoted. If they're promoting for months and months and months coronavirus, and more people have died from the flu, what are we doing? It's just, don't feed into negativity. Stop watching so much fucking TV. And that's what I like about our culture. I can honestly say we live our lives. We out riding, we out doing things, working out, doing all type of stuff. A lot of people are not doing that, and that's why this culture is so hated, because we do so much for the community. None of these other groups are really doing stuff for the community, because they're too busy watching TV and their program. They're worried about the coronavirus and buying up all the toilet paper tissue at Walmart. So listen, stay woke. Don't let these people control your life and have you thinking negative thoughts, because if you keep thinking negative, 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 that's all you're gonna get in return. So let me know in the comments how you feel about what I was saying. Shout to everybody that's been supporting. Share it with your friends so that we can grow even more. Spread the community. We're gonna be doing meet and greets this year. Crazy bike events. I wanna go all over, man. We're gonna do a lot of things this year. I got music coming. Check out for that very soon. Check my cousin Sunny Day, and he got a lot of music out right now. I'll link that down for you. And thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.